Welcome to this session about Perl's remote application server. My name is Yuri Averkiev. I'm a program manager for this product based out of Singapore. I've been with the company for 18 years.
Wow. The first guy in Singapore.
Yeah. Have not prepared any slides about Singapore, about next 2 weeks.
But we've been there already.
Been very, very beautiful, so don't have any zippers, unfortunately. How many of you actually know about our company, about Perl's? Okay. Good. So Perl's started about 20 years ago, and most of the people know us about this product. It's Perl's Desktop for Mac. It's actually Perl's Desktop, Alex, not Fusion.
Yeah, I know. Sorry about that.
It's okay. So which is pretty much today the de facto standard for running virtualized Windows on the Mac. Unless you have an enterprise agreement with VMware and get Fusion for free. So 4 years ago, we released Perl's Mac Management for Microsoft SCCM, which allows you to manage Macs through SCCM, same way you manage Windows devices. And 3 years ago, we acquired a company called 2X, and the primary reason for that was our product, Remote Application Server. And just notice, so I will be using the name Perl's Remote Application Server and Perl's RAS interchangeably because we are in process of renaming the product. Just Perl's Remote Application Server is too freaking long name to put in UI and documentation and everywhere, so we are making it shorter, but presentation uses both names. So Perl's Remote Application Server is all-in-one application and desktop delivery solution which delivers applications and desktops through RDSH. So we sit on top of Microsoft RPT protocol or through VDI. On the server side, extremely easy to deploy, extremely easy to get started, and extremely easy to maintain. On the client side, we try to optimize client experience with streamlined clients, which is available for all the major desktop and mobile operating systems. And oh yeah, I forgot to mention, so server side, we have only single console, so unlike others, there are no multitude of consoles, just one. So I'm, you'll try not to say, not to sound like I'm doing a sales pitch. I'm not from the sales team, but since this is sort of educational session, I will just be giving you an overview of what the product is all about, and everything I say is true, and everything works, of course. So how we help with YT, with people who are actually going to be evaluating the product, running POCs, and hopefully eventually supporting it in the production environment. Very easy to deploy, single installer, single MSI installer. You just install it in five minutes. And when we have quick startup users, which allow you to quickly get your environment up and running. And then you manage it through your central administration also. Security, not much to say about it. Obviously, everything is secure. All the communications are secure between internal components, between our clients. On the client side, we have a built-in support for two-factor authentication, DeepNet, SafeNet and Radius, as well as support for smart cards on Windows and other platforms. User experience, again, something we take very seriously together with ease of deployment and everything. Because basically, at the end of the day, your users will be using the product, and if we have a smooth experience, it means we're not calling to support desk, and the IT is not spending time supporting the users. Public private clouds, basically again, are flexible to deploy. You can deploy it on-premise, can deploy it in Azure, AWS, or through a hybrid deployment to support disaster recovery scenarios. And again, talking about flexibility, so if you need to publish applications, we support Windows all the way from 2016 all the way to 2003, which we probably will be dropping next year, but as of today it is supported. Same goes for remote PC publishing, Windows 10 all the way to Windows XP. Again, probably we'll be dropping Windows 16 next year, but not yet.
if you are doing...
Can I ask a question about that?
Yes, sure.
Well, we have discussed on this conference once in a while that, that although in the perfect world there would be no more XPs, no more group RTP servers, we still see some legacy systems that is really tough to convert and find other solutions for. So would it be possible to run at least the current version of your software for some years if that is necessary?
Yes, yes, absolutely. So basically, by dropping support, I mean we will not be longer testing new releases with old operating systems. It might work actually, but might not. On a VDI front, so we are not locking you into a single virtualization platform. You are free to choose Zen Server, sorry to say, E6, Hyper-V, or KVM. We added support for KVM in July this year. And we also added support for hyper-converged solutions like Nutanix, Acropolis. And already mentioned AWS and Microsoft, so not much to say about it. I have two slides with not worthy features because there are quite a few of us, so I tried to pick the ones which would appear to the most of the people. So application and desktop delivery is obviously kind of obvious feature. But what I wanted to highlight is support for Turbo.net. How many of you are familiar with Turbo.net? Okay, quite a few people. So for those who are not familiar, it is a technology which allows you to put an application in a container in a sandbox environment, so pretty much similar to FV. So what we've done, we actually have integration with Turbo.net for application publishing. So when you publish application, we can connect to Turbo.net repository, download application container, and publish it the same way you publish a regular application. I will show it during the demo. Load balancing, so we have a built-in load balancer for our components and the RDSH servers. Again, straightforward to configure, and it comes as part of your standard license. So you don't require to purchase any additional licenses to have load balancing. And pretty much actually, without standard license, you get all the capabilities. There are no add-on licenses whatsoever.
If I can supply just a little with that, it's actually kind of nice that you said that about the console. But then if you hear there's a Linux appliance used for load balancing, you would expect I need to do some command line stuff. But actually, you just give it an IP address, and from the console, you set it up, and it's actually pushing the configuration to the Linux, which is being set up automatically.
Yep.
That's kind of nice.
Yep. So PowerShell API, we introduced real usable API about a year ago. Since then, we have seen a tremendous growth in PowerShell usage. And some folks in the community, they have done really cool stuff, like Freak Berson, who is, I think, in another session.
Hi,
Freak. So yeah, he created an Azure Resource Manager template, which allow you to script deployment of RAS into Azure. Like takes 25 minutes, you go drink your coffee, come back, your RAS environment is provisioned. Okay. So really cool stuff, so available on our GitHub if you want to take a look. So I already mentioned our console, so again, single console, which is easy to use, and, well, it just works. New capability which we released actually just 2 weeks ago is a performance monitor, which is a web-based dashboard which allows you to view historical and real-time data on your environment. So we monitor FDSH servers, VDI servers, and show it in a very nice web UI integrated into console as well, or can be viewed in a standalone web browser. Universal printing, not much to say about it. It works, well, it has some problems sometimes with tricky drivers, but most of the time it works, available on all the platforms, including HTML5. Client device manager, it's a unique feature of RAS, which allows you to convert a user PC into managed device. And see, once you've done it, you can control the PC, like you can shut down, you can log off user, you can schedule his session or send a message to user. And there is also a kiosk capability about which I will talk a bit later. Parallels client policy is similar to GPO, and actually what Parallels client is our application which users run to access published applications and desktops, so similar to receiver. We call it Parallels client. So with policies you can enforce settings on the client and prevent users from modifying settings. HTML5 client is the easiest way to get started with Rust, so there is no need for you to deploy Parallels client to end users. Just point a web browser and you're ready to go. We support desktop as well as mobile browsers. One of the cool things about it is support for white labeling. So you can create a custom company branding with images, color theme, and assign it to a particular group of users. So again, Parallels client is what we use to, our users use to access published applications and desktops. Available on all the platforms, what's not listed here is Windows Phone, where are like 5 users left. So. But we no longer maintain the Windows Phone version, and we are working on a version for Windows Store. Coming
I
next
see
year.
That's the HTML file.
Sorry about that. So as of today, you get the best performance with the Windows client because it automatically, well, Windows desktop client. Because it automatically gets all the support for all the latest RDP features and remote effects. But non-Windows clients were not far behind as far as performance is concerned. One particular thing about Windows client is support for kiosk mode. Basically, with kiosk mode, you can lock down user's PC. For example, you can disable access to start menu, access to control panel, to Windows Explorer. And this kiosk mode is very popular with our educational customers, where we enable it on shared PCs, on PCs shared by students. And allow students just to use Parallels client and published applications, and I guess we need to check your Facebook on your mobile devices also. Mobile clients, so what we call brilliant mobile client experience, and the problem we are trying to solve is because mobile users, they use Windows applications, desktop applications, which were never designed to be used on a mobile device. And it is a challenge, and with our mobile clients, we try to make this experience a little bit more enjoyable and productive. So we implemented support like for native text selection, so on iOS devices it looks like iOS selection, on Android like Android selection, gestures, pitch to zoom, and all stuff, again, is supported when you're using our clients. For the iPad users who want to turn their iPad into desktop replacement, we implemented support for external mouse, Bluetooth mouse from SwiftPoint. So currently we support this particular model only. It's like small tiny mouse, very cool. And yeah, experience is just like you are using your, I don't know, MacBook or ThinkPad, very cool. But again, if you need to use a touch interface, we have different mouse modes, like there are three modes, which you can switch depending on your user scenarios. And quick keypads is another new capability. It's ability to define custom shortcuts, which appear on top of the standard mobile keyboard, and which allow you to quickly execute various published application menu items. I will show it during demo, because it's actually easier to demonstrate. And I think the demo is coming now, so. So basically what you see is our console, and you start.
Don't move.
Oh, okay. Is this
there's
one?
A mouse button on the.
Okay, I'm not touching. So what you see is our console, and you start with startup wizards. This is application publishing, and the last step is to invite users. So basically, you select on which OSs where you get to install client. You select target users, and after that, an email will be sent to those users. basically we click on email, client gets installed and all the connections are registered. So this is view that shows all the servers and infrastructure, some performance data, CPU, RAM, and number of sessions. Next one is a designer, which shows like bird's eye view of the infrastructure. You can click on item, like go to RDSH server and, for example, configure UPD settings. We can keep existing settings, which are already configured, or customize those. Sorry. And next one, VDI. So as I said, we support multiple VDI providers, so you can choose whichever you want. Including KVM. We did not see much use of KVM yet, but hopefully it will increase. Gateway is our server components, which performs tunneling of connections as well as access HTML5 gateway. You have options to launch Parallels client instead of using HTML5 when you're launching application, and different options. So themes is our interface to create custom branding. So basically you define different colors, your company branding, login and logoff messages, language bar, and footer links, which are shown at the bottom. And so this is how our standard theme on HTML5 client looks. So you log in, you get your applications, and this is a custom branding. So. And depending on the user, you can have a different set of applications, obviously. This is a logon message, which I defined, but currently this demo is like the same set of applications. And it's configured to launch applications inside the HTML5 session instead of using the native client. But again, experience is just like you are using a native client. At the bottom, we have taskbar to switch between applications. This allows you to upload files and download files to your server, as well as to transfer clipboard. And also at the bottom you get what's footer links you can, which you can define.
Where are they defined?
In the theme, yeah, as part of the custom branding. So this is application publishing, and so what it will show is how to publish turbo.net application. So we call it containerized application. We automatically connect to Turbo, fetch list of your categories and applications. So you can just browse it, or you can search Turbo repository. Like select Firefox, you get a publishing screen, which looks exactly the same as if you have your publishing regular application, just different command line. And when we can launch it, so basically first time we launch Turbo.net application, what we do, we download application container from Turbo, automatically install it on RDSH server, so first launch takes a little bit longer than usual. Depending on the connection, might be like 10 or 15 seconds, but subsequent launches,
Can you pre-cache?
Yes, you can. So, and this is basically Firefox running in a container. It gets an icon at the bottom, so just like a regular application. And this is performance dashboard, which is new, again, was released two weeks ago. So it shows information about sessions, CPU usage, RAM, disk, and network. So we plan to add additional counters to this dashboard because initially it was conceived as our internal project.
Can you export the reports?
Yes, you can. So basically what you see is it's called Grafana. It's a free web-based dashboard. And this is our policy, which allows to customize Parallels client settings. Actually, next year we're going to bring lots of new functionality to this, like much more granular policies comparing to what we have today. Okay, so this is desktop, and let me show you mobile client. So this is our mobile client, and we support connection to our Rust servers as well as native RDP connections with what I have on the left. So I connect to establish connection to Rust. The screen looks similar to native iOS screen with folders and all. Even with search, we try to mimic iOS behavior or Android behavior on Android. And when you launch your session, okay, the first time takes a little bit longer. And what I want to show you is how native text selection looks like. So you need to type some text. And then double tap on it, and you see the selection looks like a native iOS selection, and the behavior is the same, and the menu on the top as well. And next I will, let me slow it down a little bit more. So basically, what you see here, oh, back to the mouse, really cool. So this part is what we call quick keypad. Basically, you define custom shortcuts, like copy paste. It's so you define like Control C, Control V, or whatever. And when we display those shortcuts here, you can nest what. So like file menu, it actually will get you to another level with another shortcuts. And the use case for this feature sometimes. It's much easier just to execute shortcut comparing to going through the menu here, right? Clicking file, selecting menu item. So for actions which you use often and which in application have a shortcut assigned, it's much faster to just use our quick keypads. So basically, I think I click on paste, and when I can go to into file, so at the next level, it's additional comments, and I click on save, and yeah, where you go, you save as comment. Next, so mouse mode, again, three different modes. Like, this is what we call Dumbo mouse. And actually, Citrix in the latest release, we copied this Dumbo mouse. We didn't have it before. Now we have it. And when you can switch to a pointer mode, which is a little bit different, so you get your buttons at the bottom to perform your left and right clicks. And when we have additional settings, like you can change desktop resolution, you can change both resolution as well as DPI scaling. Unfortunately, we need to log out user to apply DPI settings, but it's up to Microsoft. Printing, again, printing is supported from mobile clients as well. And what's next? This is application switcher, so if you have multiple applications running, we can switch between those. And I think the next one, last one is change domain password. So you can change domain password. Can be done from mobile client as well as from desktop clients as well. Okay. So basically what I want you to remember about our product is it is a very flexible and easy to use application and desktop delivery solution which really adapts to your needs with architecture which scales up and scales down, security which can be you can tighten security and you can tighten even more according to your requirements. I mentioned licensing, so the product is licensed per concurrent user. With subscription pricing is $100 per user or 100 euros. We have postpaid, prepaid, as well as permanent licenses. Permanent licenses may cost a little bit more. So all-in-one solution which includes load balancer, again part of the standard license, native clients for all the platforms including HTML5, and according to some research study, external study, some customers saved on TCO 60% by switching from Citrix to Rust, and end of life for 6.5 is coming, so well, we welcome most Citrix users. Trial is available, so three options for trial. Just install, download MSI installer, We have a Hyper-V virtual machine with the trial, or you can try it in Azure and AWS. 30 days, 50 concurrent users. And that's it. Any questions?
Can you explain how the universal printer part is working? Is it like the Citrix universal printer, or how is it?
So we piggyback on what Microsoft provides to us, but we also customize it as well, so it's a little bit different from the Citrix.
But it's still sent as a print job from the server, is it transferred to the client and then spooled there?
No, we spool it to the server.
Okay. Also, maybe you didn't mention right now you cannot do also you cannot use hypervisor. The hypervisor part for RDS for the servers, right?
Yes, correct. It's something we consider implementing next year at 16.5.
Yeah.
It's either going to be 16.5 or 17. So yeah, you can talk about it. Actually, we had internal discussion just recently. It's a good feature to push.
Do you have any license feature for like MSPs?
Yes, we do.
You do?
Yes. And for MSPs, we are also working on the multi-tenancy support. So we sort of have multi-tenancy now, but what we plan to implement next year is going to be much more comprehensive.
Is that a new console or just a...
No, it's likely going to be same console. Good. Thank you very much.